Sup, driver timers. This is 23A. This is the famous 23rd episode, about which point the series has jumped the shark. Drive time. It's a drive time for a Wednesday, 8:59 Eastern Standard. March. Oh, caught myself. April. It's April. We're 3 days in. Third day of April. 2013. Welcome to the program. You are listening to my talk show. My name is Rian, and I am happy to be here. I'm from New Jersey. I live in New Jersey. The skies you're seeing right now are New Jersey skies. Gorgeous blue skies. Still a little colder than you'd want it to be, but we're getting there. We're getting there. I saw the Meat Puppets last night, but I mean, what's on my mind is the, if you haven't heard, is the Rutgers basketball scandal with Coach Mike Rice. And I don't want to talk about it because I want to try something. I want to try to see, oh shit, I was going to try and get that out of that light, but oh, okay, no, that was not a bad idea. I mean, it's one smart decision. I'll see if I can make many more in a row today, and that'll be a good day. But here's the thing with the basketball story. If you're familiar with this program, I'm a Rutgers supporter. And the video that leaked of the coach abusing the players is bad. And there's nothing, I'm not going to try and justify it or really talk about it at all. It just is what it is. But the media cycle, I'm going to attempt, starting right after I talk about it here for the next minute and a half, to de-engage fully. Full de-engage. Just I'm only going to listen to music. I'm not going to listen to sport. Like, I'm a sports fan, and I'm a Rutgers guy, but I can't deal with this. I don't think that the AD, the athletic director, should lose his job over this. I think they should get rid of the coach as soon as possible, and profusely apologize profusely, I guess makes a better way to word that, for not having fired him immediately, because there's a lot going on here, and I'm gonna say I don't want to get into specifics, because it'll rattle my brain, and it'll throw me off doing things that I really make me happy. So I could spend all day today on the internet and looking for you know, blips and updates on this story. But I can't do it, and I'm going to turn off as soon as I'm done talking about it. Now I'm going to do my best to purge myself from that kind of media connectivity. You know, if I see something, I don't follow a lot of sports Twitter guys. Luckily, I think I follow too many people as it is, so it's a blur, and I don't read all the tweets. I should probably par down, but whatever. I mean, it's fucking stupid, but I seem to, even though I heard about this on Twitter, and one of the sports guys, it was actually Peter King, which is odd, football, everyone had to chime in, though. God forbid, LeBron James, what was LeBron James' thoughts about the Rutgers basketball scandal? Oh, we know, let's put that on, that's important. LeBron James just chimed in, I can go to sleep tonight. Everyone's got an opinion. Everyone's opinion is founded on a visceral reaction to a 30-second video. And that's fine. And I'm not judging people for having that. But this is the way of the world. Everyone now feels this need to immediately chime in. Maybe the appropriate response to any scandal or anything is to just not chime in. There's plenty of people who are going to try and right this ship. And you know what? They're probably going to do a crappy job. They're probably not going to get everything right. They're probably going to fuck up a lot of shit even more, you know, even more so than it's already been fucked up. That's life. That's what happens. There's no perfect solution here to a situation like this, which is just bad all around. Because it hurts a lot of people. And it hurts more people than you would even probably think. And I don't see the point in just the endless just give my opinion game. of the 24-hour news cycle. I need to take myself out of that equation. Because as a fan, even, and as a, you know, you look at all the other big sports stories, or just in news stories in general, I can't. I try not to. I mean, I get caught up in it. I got caught up in the Penn State. I only tune out when it happens to me type of attitude either. I think it's just tuning out in general is good. I don't know what good comes of just the endlessly, the endless barrage of just repetitive things. I mean, this is a story that could have been broken by any number of journalists for a long time that wasn't. I can go around, my opinions are where they are, and I don't feel the need to share them, because who the fuck am I? Okay, who the fuck am I? That's, stop, and you know, what would Jesus do bracelets? He's at who the fuck am I, at WTFAI bracelets. So instead of saying, what would Jesus do, just instead say, who the fuck am I, to even say, I am, no. What am I even talking about? I gotta end the show. My media diet starts now. We'll be looking at Twitter, but not, like I said, my sports feed and Twitter can sometimes get buried and I don't see a lot of things. I'm not clicking any links. That's my promise. Okay, have a great day.